Okay, so we're going to have a little look at how to loop the game. So in other words, when you run out of lives, or when you end the game, then it will give us an option to restart the game. Now, what we've got to do is we've got to add a loop. Okay, now, just up here, so this is kind of the start of the game. Almost at the very top, you can see I've got a couple of other things at the top, and I've got the game over procedure, which if you haven't already done, you're going to need to go and do that first before you do this. Okay, so just head back to the game over video to make this before you can do the loop. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I've got a loop, and we're going to call it a while loop. Okay. And the way I've written it is like this: while again is equal to yes. Okay. Now, up here, I've written a variable called again, and I've set it to yes. So if you imagine again is like a switch that switches on or off our loop. Okay. So while again is equal to yes, the game will keep running. If again is equal to something different, like no, what we want is the loop to end and the game to end, okay? But while it's yes, we want the game to continue, okay? So we're saying while again is equal to yes, anything indented under here will need to continue. Now, I've mentioned the word indented, okay? So if you remember, indentation means pushing the code in, tabbing the code in. So it, what this means is if the code is indented, it belongs to the bit above it. So a bit like an if statement that you've done before. So here, the code that's indented belongs to this if statement. Okay. Now, obviously, we've got to indent the whole game. Okay. So that's quite a lot of tabbing. So there's a quick way of doing it. If you highlight everything underneath the while loop, so not the while loop, anything underneath it, so like this. Okay. Like so, and then what we want to do is indent all of this at the same time. Now, depending on what editor you're using, it might be an edit or format or something, but you're looking for something which says something like indent or indent code, indent region. And if you click that, that will just indent everything inside the loop. Okay, so we can see now everything is indented. Okay, so we want to make sure that all of our code is indented. If it's not, we're going to get an error or it won't appear in the loop. The only code not indented is anything above the while loop. Okay. So what we're saying is at the moment, again is equal to yes. And while again is equal to yes, anything indented will loop around. Okay. Now, the next step here. What we've done is in game over, I've just added a couple of extra bits. And I've added an input statement which says, do you want to continue, yes or no? And the variable for that input statement is again. And if you remember, I mentioned again was like a switch. If we set again to yes, the loop will continue. If we set it to no, the game will end. Okay. So if the user types in no, first of all, here, then the game will stop. Okay. If they type in yes, then we're going to set the again variable to yes, okay? We may not even need that actually because we've already set it to yes there. And then we're going to print loading game, and I've just done a sleep for 3 seconds just to pause the game while it's re-looping, okay? And then here I've got some code that says return again. So what this means, it's going to take whatever we typed in here, as yes, okay, so we type yes in to continue the game, and it's going to return yes back to the main game, okay? So it sounds a bit complicated, but basically it's keeping that again switch on yes. And in the main game, and if you've already done the game over procedure, you will know that you've got something like that, which controls whether the game, whether the amount of lives is zero or not. Okay, so we've made a little addition to this. We've done again equals game over. So we're saying whatever is returned from game over, which in this case is going to be the variable again, so which will be yes. The variable again will be assigned to whatever comes out of game over. So in other words, yes. So we're saying if again is equal to yes, then continue. And what this does in Python, this will stop the game here and it will move back to the top of the loop and it will check, is again equal to yes? It is. So the loop continues, okay? And the game will continue again, all right? Now, a couple of other things I've done here, just to bear in mind. Every time we used game over previously, we now need to use this little section of code here, okay? So, for example, down here, I've used game over again to check if we've lost all our lives. So I've added that section of code, okay? So this is the thing that's going to keep the game going if the user says they want to continue. So you can see again just here and so on, okay? So anytime you've used game over, you're now going to need to put this section of code with it, okay? Now, a couple of other things. At the start of the game, so we start the game, the loop goes, I've then set again to no, so it's a switch again. So what I mean here is if the user doesn't want to carry on with the game at the end, the loop won't go again, so the game will just end, okay? Now, what I've also put down the bottom is another input. So at the end of the game, it will ask them if they want to play the game again. So say they get through the game and they've won, it'll ask them if they want to play again, okay? If they do, they type yes, and remember the switch again, as long as it is set to yes, the game will continue. If it's switched to no or anything else, it will print bye and the loop will end, okay? So let's see this in action, okay? Now the key thing to remember here is again, as I say, is like a switch. If it's set to yes, the game will continue. If it's set to no, the game will end. So let's just run an example so we can see what happens. So we're going to type in the name of the adventurer and we'll just do the first section just to show you. So let's say I've set my lives to one. So in other words, I'm going to die straight away if I put the wrong option in. So I'm going to put the wrong option in, R. Now you see here, we're out of lives, so it's asking us, do you want to continue? Okay, so this is this section up here. And if we say yes, it will return whatever again is back to the game, which in this case is here. Okay, and it will do continue, which means it will go back to the start of the loop and carry on. Okay, so if I do yes, okay, loading game. And the game continues, starts at the start again, okay? So this time, if I go through and die again, but this time select no, so I'm gonna run away. No, I don't wanna continue, okay? So at this point, the loop will finish, okay? Because what I've done is I've said up here, okay, if we say no, thanks for playing, game ends, okay? So it's slightly complex and we're actually veering into something that's kind of like GCSE standard here. So if you're at this point, you're doing very, very well. But if you want to try the loop to keep the game going, that's how you go about doing it.